If you're a stargazer or just like to look through binoculars, but you have trouble with stabilization and you can't really see that well, I think you might be interested in this next interview. We're with Carrie McTaggart from NexOptic. Is that the way I say it?
NexOptic Technology Corp, yes.
All right, great. So this is audio and video. So describe in audio what you're showing us here.
Absolutely. So as you can see in the front here, this is a two-camera system. So this is a wide field lens and a narrow field lens. Essentially right here, this is a high optic telescope. What our founders have done is create a very powerful telescope that essentially what you would see in 5 feet, you can see within 5 inches. So this is our first device that we're coming to market with this technology.
So let me describe the box she has in her hands. It's maybe 3 inches high by 6 inches wide by another 3 inches deep. And it's a nice black matte finish. And it's got a, looks like this is a lens cover if I flap it over correctly.
That's correct.
So it's got two sides to it. One side is the camera in the center, is the high optical zoom, is that correct?
That's correct.
And then down on the bottom left of that is the wide angle lens.
That's correct.
And you're combining those images in software, I guess?
Well, what we're actually doing here is we are enabling the consumer to be able to see far range distances and being able to change from a wide view to a narrow view.
So she's pressing buttons on the top of it. She's got kind of a canned photo stored inside the unit right now to demonstrate, because there's nothing interesting here at CES. And she's demonstrating zooming in and out, and she's showing that she can change the zoom. Basically, it's from 10x to, what is the wide angle?
Wide angle is just a
one
typical...
One-to-one?
Yes. But this is a 10 times optical zoom piece of technology.
So you're not having to hold this up to your eyes, but it is like binoculars.
That's exactly right. And you actually bring up a really great point, because I already see that you're wearing glasses. So with a typical set of binoculars, you put them up to your eyes, people with glasses are already at a disadvantage. So this would be very accommodating for a lot of consumers. That being said as well, there can be more than two eyeballs on this device. So it's great.
Oh, right, right.
Great for group sharing. This could change the game for educators, it could change the game for military, a lot of applications, both vertical and horizontal.
So stargazing is the first thing I think of. Can you change the brightness of the display for when you're outside?
Absolutely. And of course, the sun exposure is always a variable, so this is going to be a very bright screen. So that it's...
What about at night?
It's going to be very bright, so you'll be able to see at night.
No, but usually you need it to be dimmer at nighttime because you're stargazing, you don't want it too bright.
Of course, you can adjust it to be lower.
Oh, okay, good. Bright when you need it. And then on the top, we've got a couple of buttons here. Is that the zoom button?
That is zoom in, zoom out.
It's just two toggles, though. You're not continuous zoom. It's in or out?
Great question. So for our prototype, it's just zoom in, zoom out. For our final device, you're going to be able to... It does have that fire focus because it's working with those two cameras, but then you're going to be able to get to that 1 degree view using that far view.
Okay, so you'd be able to smoothly zoom in and out between them?
Yes.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
So you said something about viewing this on a smartphone.
Absolutely. So let's say that you're out in the woods and, you know, you want to be able to share with your friends or family or colleagues, even at a gym, etc. You're going to be able to share what is on the screen with other smartphones. So you can have this, you can have this image with other smartphones around you.
And okay, that's a little creepy to use binoculars at a gym, but let's go stargazing again, shall we? We're looking at the bear that's coming up on the campsite, maybe.
Absolutely. Yeah, stargazing, NFL games, making that cheap seat the best seat.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, that's a good application.
Absolutely. Another application would be whale watching. When you're out there together and you're trying to point and have a group experience, you can't have that with a binocular. It's a single user experience. This is going to change that game.
This ends the let me look.
Exactly.
All right, so if people want to learn more about this, where should they go?
www.nexoptic.com.
And that's NexOptic.com. And when do you think this is going to be available?
We're looking for third quarter 2019.
Oh, hot dogs. Do you have a price point yet?
About $1,500 American.
Ooh, okay. Well, this is for this serious football game watcher.
Well, that being said as well, when you're looking at binoculars like the Swarovski, they're about $4,000 and they're not they're not even smart at all. And when you're looking at DSLR, you're already looking at a $2,000 camera. On top of that, they're not water resistant. So if you drop this on a rock or in a little puddle, don't worry about it. But you're not going to have that forgiveness with a DSLR camera.
There you go. All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.